musician Michael Bix, and I am sitting here with the Melba Moore. Welcome to just the atmosphere. I just talked to Howard. He said, I called him a legend. He said, don't do that.
Well, he is.
I don't even know what to say. I know I've done this a million times. I am speechless.
Well, I'm glad you're excited.
I am glad to sit here and get to talk to you. I can say Melba Moore, and I was telling my kids earlier today, we can run down the history.
Well, it's Black History Month.
Well, let's...
I don't know when this will air, but we're still in Black History Month. So
come on, let's just talk about from the tip of... Where is Melba Moore? I mean, what is she doing? What's her past, present, future?
I'm not going to give it all to you.
Well, give us a little bit.
But for the last, I guess, I'll start with November because it really kind of started end of the year 2019 and came into this incredible year 2020, which I know is going to be perfect vision, 2020 vision.
Clear, yes.
Well, I mean, Jesus got 2020 vision, but he's giving it to us.
Yes.
So November, the whole month of November through February, I spent on Norwegian Cruise doing the Broadway production of After Midnight. Did you know anything about that production?
No.
It's, do you ever remember seeing any movies of the Nicholas Brothers?
Yes.
Maybe dancing all the time?
Yes.
It's that kind of a show.
Yeah, oh.
And that kind of dressy formal wardrobe of the Harlem Renaissance.
Yes.
And... the time of Ella Fitzgerald and Lena Horne and Sarah Vaughan and Cab Calloway and Willie S. Stein and on and on and on and on and on. That's what After Midnight's about. When they started to have Uptown, I think you probably started, I shouldn't take credit for this, but the speakeasies.
Yeah.
After Midnight means after everything else closes down, then we start to party. And that's where all the... That culture that has been handed down to us came from. And the show's called After Midnight.
After Midnight.
And on Broadway, I think the first artist to be what they call the star singer was Fantasia.
Mm.
And then after that, I think there was Patti LaBelle and there was all these wonderful icons that came in to do what they call the featured singer or the star singing role. And that's the part that I did on Norwegian Cruise. And they dressed me impeccably because you know the wardrobe and the costumes that, well, you remember seeing pictures if you're too young of Cap Calloway and his tails.
Yes. I wish I was too young, but I'm not. So seen it all. I love it.
I mean, you know, when they brought
that
to Hello Dolly on Broadway, starring Pearl Bailey, you know, just an iconic way. So that's what I've been doing from November to February.
You had fun?
Fun? I was ecstatic. I mean, I sang songs like, Stormy Weather.
Wow.
I Can't Give You Anything But Love. Zazu Zaz is a song like the way Cab Calloway used to scat. You know how Cab Calloway would scat. And then we know how Ella Fitzgerald would scat. But they created scat. So, yes, I had fun. After that, I've been on it quite a few times. There's a new organization called Women of Color on Broadway, which means that we step into a new day. Where there have been so many iconic African Americans starring on Broadway, we can now honor ourselves. So it's going to be similar to the Drama Critics Award, the Theatre World Award, all the awards adding up to the Tony Award, which is the highest award you can get for Broadway theater, which I have. But I've been honored by this new organization. And when you see some of the people that they honor, like Chita Rivera, Rita Moreno, and the Latinos and women that have done incredible things, but have not been honored really by the realm in this iconic way. Because there haven't been any organizations that had the kind of stature yet.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
But we're coming into our own to the point where we can honor our own. And then there was the 50th anniversary, I can't believe it's been this long, of the opening of the musical Pearly, because I don't know if you know. Pearly Victorious was first what we call a straight comedy. And it was written by Ossie Davis for himself and Miss Ruby Dee.
Mm-hmm.
And then they did a little movie of it. But then they rewrote it and put music to it and brought it back to Broadway. And it starred Cleavon Little, myself, Sherman Hemsley. If anybody's ever watched Law and Order, you've seen Novella Nelson. You may not remember or know who Linda Hopkins is, but she's an incredible gospel singer. And I'm, I think Debbie Allen was in the chorus as a dancer. George Faison was in the chorus.
Can you imagine having all of those?
That's what I'm trying to say, everybody, to say, you know, the type of incredible talents and long-lasting, business people, because you can't just have the talent. You have to learn how the industry works and then continue that. Now, Debbie Allen, of course, is the sister of Felicia Rashad.
Correct, right.
And then, of course, she went on to star with Bill Cosby. You know, he's had his challenges, but guess what? He's back.
Come on back. Yeah.
So, I've been doing those kinds of things. I have a new CD. And it's really my first gospel CD. Because I'm not technically a gospel singer. I'm a Broadway singer. But I'm a born-again Christian.
Now,
listen. You know about
this. Yeah, now you're talking my language.
Okay.
Listen, earlier when we...
I'll stop talking.
No, you're doing great.
If you want to ask a question,
you're doing... No, you're doing... You're doing great.
When I was talking about... This is how I finished 2019 and begun 2020. And of course, I'm here at the Sheldon Theater.
2020, that's a year double.
Yeah. Double what?
Double blessings.
No, not just double.
Double everything.
Let me ask you something, Bishop. Who is 1, 2, 3?
Ooh, it's 1, 2, 3. I can give you my version. Yeah. Ah, the Son and the Holy Ghost.
I thought you knew that. So who is 2?
2 means double.
No. Who is it? I didn't ask you what it means. I said, who is it?
Preach.
No.
No, I'm
preach,
telling
preach
no,
is something
look,
you
I'm telling you too.
I got lost in
look,
the
Look, the reason I'm saying that is because this
I'm
is I want you to. That's why you're
okay,
listening to Hello Sunshine. But here's what, this is amazing. This is what the Holy Spirit just did. Where you're leading and leading on this part, that's what Howard did.
That's who he is.
We didn't get to go.
My point is, that's who all the creatures are. Because you already know that.
I preach. I turned the pool up
but
over
you didn't
here.
Answer me. Who is 2?
Give me who you 2.
It's the second person of the Blessed Trinity. Okay. Who is that?
Father, Son.
Who is the Son?
Jesus.
Well, just say Jesus.
Look, I want to make sure we're headed on the. This is how
ain't
it's
nowhere
been.
To go
this is
it.
How it's been all day.
It's always been that way.
This is how it's been. So that's. Look, Howard was a. We were talking earlier about him being a renegade. You know, I know I've been called and all that good stuff. And, you know, he got emotional because he was talking about his roots in gospel, his roots in God.
His roots were in gospel.
And how this thing worked. And
so my roots are, I was born Catholic. You know, that's the church that Jesus started.
Okay.
That's the first Christian church.
Right.
So I left it, you know, like every other dumb fool. But Spirit just involved me into coming back to the Catholic Church because all the relics and remnants are for you to go to Israel or Rome or anywhere and see physically what he did. And nobody says it
right.
Because we think it's denominational. It's not.